Hello, good morning. We are joined today by Rob Gratton, CEO at Clean Seas Seafood. Rob, good morning to you. How are you?
Morning, Joel. Great to be with you.
Glad to be with you as well. Listen, you've had some pretty impressive numbers in your results for the first half of the financial year. Give us a bit more details about these numbers.
Yeah, thanks, Joel. Look, we're very proud of the result that we put out to the market a couple of weeks ago. Obviously, trade has been strong for us for some time now, and it's great to see that strong trade continue with record sales and record volumes as well. But I guess what we're particularly proud about is to deliver on what we've been working on for many months now, which is to get our cost of production down, to reduce the overhang of excess inventory, turn that into low production costs, and then to be reporting production costs coming down, positive cash flows for the last 6 months. We're really pleased that we're able to show the financial viability of our business model.
Yeah, price also seems to have been a key factor in this period for you. How difficult has it been balancing price and costs?
Yeah, look, the last clearance of our surplus inventory really occurred in July and August of last year. And so since then, we've been selling what is effectively A-grade product into the market, and pricing reflects that. To be honest, pricing is a bit stronger than what we thought it was going to be. We're seeing really strong demand for this fish. We're seeing great customer acceptance. And we're really seeing, the benefits of the high-quality, sustainable fish that we're producing. And that's what we're seeing going into price. So, if there's one thing that surprised us in the result, it was just how strong price continues to be. But I guess we shouldn't be surprised, because we're growing a great species, a high-quality fish, and doing that in a very sustainable way. And that is certainly resonating in markets all around the world.
Yeah, how difficult has it been for you trying to, keep quality up in the context of trying to maintain things like sustainability, productivity and efficiency?
Oh, look, we have a great advantage. We grow a native species of yellowtail kingfish in its home waters of Spencer Gulf. So our fish in the wild breeds and grows out in those very waters. And so that gives us a great quality benefit. It gives us a great sustainability benefit. And really what we try and do is respect the biology of the fish, farm it in the right way, and then tell that provenance story to the market, which I said, as I said before, is resonating really well. People understand that growing a native species, and they understand the high quality fish, and increasingly we're seeing customers, supermarkets, home meal kits, premium restaurants all around the world asking for this fish.
Yeah, can you talk to us a little bit more about how challenging the impact of things like lockdowns and supply chain disruptions have been for you?
Yeah, sure. Particularly the first 3 months of the pandemic, when all the restaurants shut and all of the the planes stopped flying, was really challenging for us. It was challenging in terms of the market, and then also challenging in terms of the supply chain. So what we did, we responded very quickly. We sought to diversify the business, put our product into new channels and markets all around the world, and increasingly, particularly for our export markets, to leverage our low-cost, low-carbon frozen supply chain. And so, while the first 3 months of the pandemic, thinking back, 2 years ago was very challenging, our ability to really maneuver into a frozen export business and to push this fish into much more varied and diverse markets and channels around the world is really paying dividends. And what we've seen in the result most recently is, revenues up versus pre-pandemic levels. Volume is considerably up versus pre-pandemic levels. And that's the benefit of all of that hard work over the last 18 or 24 months.
Yeah, well, looking ahead to the rest of this year and beyond, what's the outlook like now for you for the rest of 2022? And what have you got coming up?
Yeah, we've seen demand continue to be very strong in the last few months since we released the result. We're certainly very bullish on the species and that the story around provenance and quality that we tell will continue to be very well accepted. And I guess the other point is that we continue to see cost of production come down. And so, we're very much looking forward to giving the market another update on both of those things at the end of the year and, focusing in on what we do well, which is grow this fish, grow it in a very sustainable way.
Great. All right. Well, look, we look forward to hearing further details about it when we check in with you next time, Rob. Thanks.
Terrific, Joel. Thanks so much.